Liberals want to allow people to use more superannuation to buy a home, but is that a good idea?
For more, let's bring in John Keogh, economics editor of the Australian Financial Review. Johnny, good morning. So how much superannuation do Liberals now want to allow people to dip into?
Yeah, good morning, Carl and Sarah. Look, the Liberals took a policy to last election to allow first home buyers to take $50,000 out of their superannuation pool. They're now suggesting a new Senate report led by home ownership spokesman Andrew Bragg that that be increased to $100,000 or maybe $150,000 or even be unlimited. So they're really doubling down on this policy. They're struggling with younger voters at the moment, the Liberal Party. They also don't really like the compulsory superannuation industry either too. So they're trying to kill two birds with the one stone here.
I'm not sure it makes anything cheaper.
Yeah, I think at the margin, Carl, this would lead to slightly higher house prices because it's obviously going to be tipping more money into an already inflated housing market. Important to note also, it's probably going to help people bring forward the purchase of homes who are already going to be first home buyers. It's probably not going to help those people who are really low income and is really struggling to get into the market because they don't have very high superannuation balances anyway.
I just don't know what we're going to do in this country with this housing crisis. I mean, you look at the state of rents, they're going through the roof. The supply level of rent of those available are in such short supply, and you've got prices of existing houses going through the roof. How does that cycle end anytime soon?
Well, it is absolutely diabolical, isn't it, Carl? And I think it's the number one, not only economic, financial issue, but social issue facing Australia too. Look, if your parents don't have wealth stored in a home in one of the big cities like Sydney or Melbourne, it's very, very difficult for young people to get into the housing market these days. I know it's a bit of a cliche, but we've got to add a lot more supply. We've got to allow more medium density in inner suburbs. That is going to help. That's going to be the best answer to this. These demand side policies are just going to inflate home prices more.
I mean, any kid out there has got no chance in the cities.
No, it's so tough and rents are paying too. But onto more important issues, of course, Johnny. The Dons playing the Giants. Are you going to get to the game down in Melbourne? Do you like your chances?
Oh, I don't like my chances of getting down there. I'll be up here preparing for the budget next week, Sarah.
Boring.
We're going to have the Treasurer Jim Chalmers on the show on Sunday, but on the Today Show. But look, I think the Giants are going to be pretty hard to beat. They're in very good form.
I'm tipping the Bombers. So
good on you, Carl.
That basically ends it for them.
Thank you, John. Mate.